Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video, we have seen how to implement a simple Jetpack navigation, and we also understood how to know what's happening in the navigation using the NavController. But now what we will do is we will put it as a part of the scaffold, and then we will use the NavController information to basically control the icon that we show in the scaffold. So let's see how to do this. So in the current structure, you have a app composable, and under that we have the navigation host, and the navigation host takes the parameter of NavController and NavGraph. The NavController is part of the app and is being passed to the nav host. But if you want to add the scaffold, structure has to slightly change. The new structure would be actually be introducing one more level of hierarchy. Your nav host will not be part of the app directly. It will be put under the scaffold, and it will be the scaffold that will be under the app. The NavController will be part of the app now. So with this basic understanding set, let's get started. So this is the same old code base, no difference. This is our activity, and here I am passing the app, and our app has the definition of NavController. Then we have the nav host, and we have created two different ways of creating the nav graph, and we are passing that. We have all covered this in the previous video. So let's get to the next level. To make it simple, here in the component, I already have created a composable called as my app scaffold. If you don't know how to create a scaffold, what scaffold is, what all the options it provides, then what I suggest is you just go back and watch one of my videos on app scaffold itself, and then you can come back. So right now we have this app scaffold, and here I need to basically pass the nav host. So what I will do is go to the app. I will create the my app scaffold. I want to be able to pass this nav controller inside the scaffold. So I should slightly modify my definition here. So let me go here and add the nav controller, and then we come back here and pass this nav controller. And this logic that I had written here can now be part of my app scaffold, and then move all of this logic to the scaffold here, and even move this to this section. But if you see here, it is complaining that this padding values is not being used. We need to pass this particular padding values because this basically is the dimension of the scaffold at the top of the screen that the screens have to accommodate if they are supposed to get rendered properly. Now, how to do this? Well, it's not that complicated. Let's pass padding values as well and update the function to receive the padding values. Not only that, you have to pass these particular padding values to the screens. It's not just sufficient that you are writing these padding values to just get rid of the compilation error. Now, what we will do is pass the padding values as a part of the modifier parameter. We can pretty much do the same for screen 2 and screen 3 as well. And we should be good after this. And now, let me run this. There's a problem. Let's remove this preview. They are complaining. And let me run this again. So now you can see that I have the scaffold. But what I still don't have is the navigation icon. That's not a problem. We can just go here. After the title, we can write navigation icon. And under that, we can write icon button on click. Let's not do anything as of now. And then under this, you can write icon image vector icons dot field dot home, and then content description nav icon as of now. So now let me just rerun this. Yeah, now I have the home button here, but this needs to change based on where I am. Right now, to do that, I would need to check what's happening in the nav controller. Okay. So what I will do is, since it is a composable, I can create a mutable state where is back enabled. Remember, mutable state of a boolean. Right now it is false, and then I can set the value of this is back enable dot value. I can check destination dot route screen one. So depending upon what value that we are getting here, we are going to set the boolean value of is back enabled to either true or false. And then here in the navigation icon, we can write our custom logic. So depending upon the value, I decide what icon I will use. And once this icon is set, I can basically pass that particular icon here. And now let me run this. Right now it is screen one. So I am having the home icon. If you can see here, when I am in screen 2, it shows back. And when I am on screen 3, then also it shows back. If I click to go on home, then it will show the home icon. But in Android, if you have this particular icon, you should be able to click on this and basically do the back navigation. Right now that is not happening because we have not added what need to happen here. That is pretty simple to do now. If negation of is dot value, then I can use nav controller and then do the pop back stack. And now let me run this. I am on screen 2, and when I click on this, I can go back. I am on screen 3, and when I click on this, I can go on screen 2, and once again when I click on this, I can go back to home. So this is where whatever the thing that we have learned in the previous video about how to work with the nav controller is actually being used to implement a simple navigation icon behavior in the app scaffold. In the next video, we will talk about how to basically pass the data from one screen to another screen, that is from one composable to another composable. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.